So indeed, the topic of today is for me towards the circular food system, and circular food system is one of the six areas in which EAT Food is actually focusing now its work in the field of innovation. I just wanted to spend 2 words about EAT Food. We are an innovation ecosystem. We are, I would say, the most important EU food innovation initiatives. We bring together partners from all over Europe. Industry, academia, startup, SMEs, and research organizations are working together to transform the food system and tackle some of the big societal challenges, such as food waste that you just mentioned before. And in fact, the importance of building a circular food system is really made urgent by the magnitude of the issue of food waste that you should just mention some of the figures that I was going to show here. So the 88 million tons, which represent 20% of food production in the EU. And as it is estimated that this could actually feed 200 million people. And the production and disposal of this food waste generates 170 million tons of CO2, which accounts for 6% of the greenhouse gas emissions of the European Union. And the global cost is the staggering 870 million billion euro. And also an interesting figure that I came across is that food waste today, reducing it could actually help us to close the gap between the food needed to feed the planet in 2050 and the food that was available in 2010 by more than 20%. So it's really an opportunity that we have here, and this has also been recognized by the United Nations SDGs, where target number 12.3 is actually asking us to halve food waste by 2030. Actually, a brief methodological explanation. In the EU context, food waste covers food loss and food waste, whereas in the UN context, there is a difference between food loss that is up to the processing stage and before the retail level, but I will stick to the general EU definition of food waste that cover the whole supply chain. And so food waste indeed happens at all stages in the value chain, as you can see here, in Europe mostly at consumption level, but this means that we need to be able to find solutions to address this problem at all stages. And I think that we're gonna also hear in the conference today some interesting solutions that tackle all the different steps. And we have to be able to mobilize all kinds of solutions in parallel, so we cannot just rely on one set of tools. And also a few words on COVID-19 was also mentioned before. At EAT Food, we evaluated the impact of the pandemic after the first lockdown, and we saw that there is an increased risk of food waste also due to COVID, particularly the primary sector, where due to the drop in demand of certain fresh produces due to the lack of seasonal workers, there is an ability to harvest certain crops and therefore generating some food waste there, but also at processing level due to measures to distancing protected staff or even staff reduction basically impair the processing of certain raw materials, and this is also generated risks of waste. Not to mention also the increase in using plastic packaging due to the hygiene concern that were associated with the pandemic. So these are some of the impacts that we see. And then allow me to say that COVID-19 is making the urgency of a food system, building a food system, even greater than before. So I wanted to summarize the advantages of cutting food waste so we can tackle food security, access, increased access to food, especially by some of the most vulnerable groups, reducing pressure on land, water, and environment, mitigate climate change, as was already mentioned before, but also reduce the cost for businesses and improve the bottom line. This is a key aspect for us and in general for deploying new solutions, because if we recognize and we are able to capture the opportunity to reduce costs and maximize profit, we are actually providing the business rationale to invest in the solutions that are going to make a difference and deliver the impact and be able to bring the solutions to the market. Because the risk is that some innovative approaches might not be uptaken because maybe the business case is not stronger enough. I will be maybe skip the next one. I will jump to this step where I wanted to basically look for a definition of what a circular food system is. There are probably many definitions that we can look at. I found this one provided by the Ellen MacArthur Foundation quite interesting, because recognize that, you know, the circular economy for food needs to emulate a natural system of regeneration so that waste does not exist, but is instead becomes feedstock for another cycle. And in such system, resources can return to the soils in the form of organic fertilizer, and some of the byproducts that are generated can provide additional value before, again, returning to the nature in a way. And this, in fact, it basically links to also what the previous speaker was talking about, is that the optimization of the biomass is essential for achieving a circular food system. So indeed, the bioeconomy is closely associated, is developing a strategy for a bioeconomy is, I would say, definitely a precondition for building a circular food system. And I will not say more here because the speaker before me already covered this point. So here I just wanted to capture the fact that at the moment we have three big strategies that are in place. So the bioeconomy strategy that was updated in 2018, the circular economy action plan, and lately also lastly the farm to fork strategy, which takes for the first time an integrated approach to the whole value chain from farm to fork. And also quite important, because in the strategy the Commission states its commitment to cut food waste in Europe by half by 2030. So it's an intention of the Commission, which eventually will have to become law. But as a precondition, we have to be able to measure food waste in Europe. So at the moment, there is no coherent system to do it. But there is a methodology that is being developed by the Commission that will help us to do that. And naturally, as you all know, building a circular food system requires the respect of a hierarchy of different strategies to manage food surplus, byproducts and waste. And also the action that we want to, that needs to be deployed, need to respect this hierarchy. The first priority is given to prevention or reduction of surplus, then to the distribution or reprocessing, or used to for animal feed, and recycling and recovering and disposal is the last possible option that needs to put in place. So innovative solutions therefore can really have an impact at all stages of the value chain, from primary production to through processing, manufacturing, distribution and consumption. And here I've just listed some, but really this is not by no means an exhaustive list, because there are so many things that can be done to build a circular food system. What I wanted also to stress here is that innovations that want to make the food system possible have to pass four key tests. So they first of all must demonstrate a positive impact that ideally should be measured by life cycle assessments, need to be economically viable, need to respect food and feed safety regulations, but also need to be accepted and trusted by the consumers that will eventually will have to buy and update them. And finally, I would like to give if I still have a couple of minutes, a very quick glance through some...
You have it.
Okay, good. A very quick glance at some of the solutions that are being developed or supported by our ecosystem at different stages. So here we have one that deals with the issue of peatlands that you can see in the picture. Peatlands are a natural carbon sink. They absorb CO2 from the atmosphere. The problem, however, is that they are also used in the production of vegetables for horticulture, and So at the moment, we are running out of people. And then in addition, the Paris Convention on Climate Change is basically putting a ban on the extraction of peat as of 2050. So this will become, this is a resource that will become scarce. And in addition, its extraction contribution to climate change. So this new startup, which is called Fiberglob, basically, is developing a peat replacement for horticulture as a substrate for horticulture production that is derived from a waste stream of the pulpwood industry. And I think this is a great example of circularity. Here we have another interesting project that is developed by a startup called Rethink Resource. The goal of this project is to enable companies to easily identify candidate size streams for valorizations to allow the matchmaking between suppliers and buyers of size streams and basically build a knowledge base, a database to that allows basically the trading of these size streams across Europe, but hopefully globally. And this platform, this online trading platform for side streams is called Circado and has been also developed with the support of some of the EAT food partners that you see here in this slide. Here we have another interesting project concerning the olive oil sector, of course, very important for Italy, but also for all the Mediterranean countries. And olive oil production generates annually more than 30 million cubic meters of olive meal wastes. And but the disposal of this olive meal waste is expensive, can be harmful for the environment, and generates a whole series of problems. So this project is therefore developing solutions to treat and valorize this waste with the process to extract some antioxidants can be used as food ingredients, and at the same time generate either valuable byproducts, helping therefore with the issue of managing the olive meal waste. And finally, another example here, this is another startup called Feltwood. They use the discarded vegetables that are generated by producers to build a sort of raw material that is used then for food packaging. So this is also a very interesting initiative that we supported through a fund to support startups during the COVID-19 period. And lastly, another interesting example. So another big problem that we have is that on average, a restaurant wastes around 30 to 60 kilos of food in a day, which is represents around 200 euros worth of food that could have been put on the menu. And so this startup called Orbisk is developing a smart camera that is installed on the top of the waste bin, which registers all food that is being thrown away up to the ingredient level. And this basically allows the food service industry to have a very detailed insight on what they are wasting and therefore to adopt strategies to avoid it and to actually to prevent it and improve again their businesses by minimizing the food waste. So these are some of the examples of initiatives that emerge and are supported in EIT Food, and there is much more, and therefore I invite you to get in touch with us, to explore our resources, and also to join our conference on the future of food at the beginning of December, where we will have a session on a circular food system to discuss the challenges and opportunities of this amazing field. So thank you. So this is all from me.